Hi students, welcome back. Coming to the next topic in the subject Object Oriented Programming Languages, C++ Standard Exceptions. You have seen so many exceptions. You know the concept of exception also. Now coming to what are the standard exceptions that we use in C++. The C++ provides a list of standard exceptions which defines in this in this way, we are just representing what type of exception that will be there, that you have to represent like this. So C++ provides a list of standard exceptions defined in like this, which we can use in our programs. These are, so here you need to write the exceptions, the different C++ standard exceptions you need to write. These are arranged in a parent-child class hierarchy. So always remember that the exceptions here that are arranged, the C++ standard exception, will be arranged in the parent-child hierarchy. Okay, the parent-child hierarchy. C++ provides a range of built-in exceptions. The base class of for all exceptions is exception only. Actually, it also provides the standard exceptions and built-in exceptions. But the base class of all exceptions, you have to remember that exception is a base class. That is a parent. All exception classes in C++ are derived from standard scope resolution operator exception class. So in this way, you need to derive the exception. So you have to write the standard because we are using the standard exception. Standard, scope resolution operator and exception class. So std is you're going to declare in the namespace. Okay, it's just like a class, we are declaring in the namespace std exception class. Let's see the different exceptions. I said this is the base class for all exceptions. Std exception is the base class. Okay, so here the different types of standard exceptions will be, this will be the parent for all these exceptions. Okay, so here this is a parent and these are all the childs for these exceptions. That means all are working on same concept, exceptions only, but each having their different role. Means some exceptions will deal only with the some type of errors, and some exceptions will deal only with the different types of concepts like that. So here one exception, standard bad allocation. So this is only this type of exception we will use whenever there is a bad allocation is there. The memory allocation, the bad allocation. Standard bad cast. Standard bad type ID. Okay, sometimes we are used to, by mistake, we are giving some different IDs. Okay, we are declared with some other data type and we are using in a different other way. So that is that throws some exception like type ID. STD bad exceptions. STD logic failures will be there. STD runtime errors. Again, this logic failure as well as the runtime errors is acts as a parent for the remaining exceptions. Okay. So now let's see what is a logic failure. So here it is acting as a parent. Means the parent exception can have so many child exceptions. Means those are all comes under the category of logic failure only. So which type of exceptions we call it as a logic failure? Domain error. Whenever you get the exception. Excuse me. Whenever you get the exception as a domain error, that represents the logic failure. And invalid argument. Whenever you get the exception as an invalid argument, that represents the logic failure. And length error. So length error is also represents the logic failure. Out of range. Out of range is also logic failures. So these are all comes under the category of logic failure. Excuse me. STD runtime error. So runtime error, what type of errors you call it as a runtime errors? Whenever the overflow is occur, whenever the underflow error occur, or range error is occur, means if it is crossing the range, then those all comes under the runtime error. Means these logic errors can be read at the time of program. Means when you're writing the program, before compiling, you can identify these logic errors. But runtime errors cannot be study starting. Okay, we can't identify that at the when we are writing up the program. So these runtime errors will be occurred. It can't read the starting of the program. Okay, so only at the runtime only these errors can be occur. Okay, so now let's see one by one. What is this exceptions to? Exception and the description. STD exception. So I said this is a base class. So for all the exception, this is a base class. It is an exception and parent class of all the standard C++ exception. So STD logic failure. So I said the logic failure is a parent for all the logical related failure exceptions. So this logic failure, it is an exception that can be detected by reading a code. So the logic, just now I said, the logic failure can be detected by reading the code. But whereas runtime error, you cannot be detected by reading the code. The exception cannot be detected by simply reading the code in case of runtime error. But in case of logic failure, you can detect the exception by reading a code. Bad exception. It is used to handle the unexpected exceptions in a C++ program. Then what about the bad cast? So this exception is generally be thrown by dynamic cast. Now std bad type id. So type id, whenever we are given different IDs for the different data types, this exception is generally be thrown by type id. And bad alloc. So this exception is generally be thrown by new. Okay, whenever the new allocation will be done, then this bad allocation will be. So whenever you are entering a new value, okay, you are entering a new value, but that space is not suitable for that value, means a bad allocation exception will be rises. Okay, so these are all the C++ standard exceptions. Thank you.